desperate now for something far, far from it. It's Matt Edwards! Yeah! Right.
Steven!
Correct. You are correct. Matt, make yourself welcome.
Thanks.
We'll get you a little glass of something.
Oh, can I?
Yes, we'll sort that out for you whilst we have a little listen to what Issy had to say when I met up with her earlier on. Issy, fellow magician, yes, douche! You did it!
Yeah.
It was such a good routine. How pleased are you that you've made it through to the final?
Very, 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 very.
Okay. Just before we started this chat, Issy said that she loved these cushions. Well, do you know what? If you win the competition, you can buy a lot of them.
Cool.
That's true. I can't give them you for free. Now, listen, Issy, what do you want to say to everybody that picked up the phone and voted for you?
Thank you, thank you, thank you so much.
Oh, I love that. So what are you going to do in the final? Give me a little tease.
It's going to involve something with my brother.
And does your brother know?
Yes.
OK. Let's hear it for Issy, everybody.
Yay!
Nice work. Yay! Oh, applause, everybody. Do you know what? She comes across so nice.
She's amazing, isn't she? She's incredible.
What has it been like backstage with all of the semi-finalists?
Do you know, it's been a really surreal experience. It hasn't been like a competition at all. We've become like this kind of close-knit family and everyone was just excited to get out there and perform for the world, you know? It's been lovely.
Oh, come on. They all want to win.
We hate each other.
Yes. Right, let's go to the phone lines. Sam, hello to you, Sam.
Hello.
Hi, Sam. You're right.
Yes, thank you. How
good,
are you?
Good, thank you very much for asking. Right, Sam, take it away, Matt. It's all yours.
Hi, Matt.
Hi, Sam.
If you became the winner of Britain's Got Talent 2017, what would be the first thing that you would put on your rider?
Oh, nice question.
Oh, that is a great question. What is the first thing I would put on my rider? Probably a full bowl of M&Ms, a fish pond, and
naturally,
and Stephen Mullen.
Yeah!
Yeah! There you go. I don't know what to say to that. Right, George is on the line. Hi, George.
Hi, Stephen.
Hello, George. Take it away.
Okay, Matt. So, since appearing on Britain's Got Talent, where is the strangest place you've been recognised?
Oh, great question. The strangest in the toilet, I think, is the strangest place. You know, when you just go for a wee and somebody looks over and says, "All right, Matt."
Yeah, it was nice.
I saw you on Britain's Got Talent. I thought you were brilliant. I'm like, thank you. I love you too.
Did you shake hands?
Yeah, we did.
Nice.
I've just thought that through.
Yeah.
What a terrible idea.
What is it like being recognised? How are you finding it? Because
it's amazing.
I wouldn't know.
Oh, Stephen. Oh, you'd love it.
Really?
Oh, you'd love it.
Maybe one
brilliant.
Day. Maybe
you
one
know, it's
day.
Really surreal. Going from being just like a normal cabaret act that performs in holiday parks and stuff to being somebody that gets recognised is a really special kind of a feeling. In fact, on the way here, I was on the train and the lady at the carriage, you order your drinks. I was like, can I have a Diet Coke, please? And she went, oh, my goodness, you're that guy from Britain's Got Talent. I was like, yes, yes,
there
I am.
You
she
are.
Went, do you want to come and sit in first class?
What a touch.
What?
What I mean.
Oh, amazing.
Lovely jubbly. Well, listen to this, right? It's now time for a question from our official roving reporter, David Watson.
Oh.
Yeah. Let's go live. To him now.
Hi, Stephen. I'm here live at Bucket's Farm, live. Martin, the farmer, he's got a question for tonight's winner.
When you are having your Sunday roast, do you prefer chicken or beef? I need to catch my chicken.
great question, David Watson. Yeah, back on the box. So chicken or beef? This is proper television.
An important question.
Yeah.
I'm a lamb kind of a guy.
Oh, he's a lamb. Of course he is.
Give me a shank any day.
Of course he is. Give me a what?
A shank.
Oh, right.
A shank, Stephen.
Right. In your honest opinion, you've got to be honest with me now.
Oh, no, I hate it when you
How
say that.
Do you rate yourself in terms of winning a competition?
Oh, not at all. I don't. It's an easy question to answer.
Why?
I didn't think I'd get this far.
Yeah, but surely now, you're now in the final.
Don't get me wrong, I want it now. Now I'm at this stage, of course I want to win. But, you know, I've seen the other couple of acts. I mean, DNA, they're incredible. Izzy, she's incredible. Carl, I mean, it's going to be impossible to choose. Yes, I want it. Where do I put myself? I'm happy just to be here, mate.
Well, listen,
and that's a rubbish answer.
No, 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 but that's, if it's honest and fair enough. We now want a cheeky exclusive on what you're going to be doing in the final. And to make it vaguely interesting, we're going to make your voice sound even funnier than it normally is. By playing microphone lucky dip. Pick a mic. Which colour?
Ooh, I'm going to go for the blue.
Blue?
Yes, okay. Please.
Good go choice. For the blue. Right. And now just tell us what you're going to do.
Señores y señores, el próximo cosa para mí, yo tengo un nuevo truco con un picto es muy especial, ¿sabes?
Not a clue. So, tell us in English. Go on, Matt. A little taster, a little tease.
Do you know what? I've planned that for my final performance, I've decided that instead of being crazy silly, I think it's time to give the audience a bit of a wow.
Wow, that's what we need. That's what we need. And it means he doesn't know what he's doing. Let's hear it from Matt!